Hi and welcome back to Sustainable Teacher. If you are new here, my name is Leticia and I'm glad to meet you. And if you've been here before, I'm glad to see you again. In today's video, we're going to learn about 3D printing, how it works, how to design things with a 3D designer, and how to print them. If this sounds interesting to you, please subscribe, hit the notification bell, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. 3D printing is quite a new thing. Probably 3D printing started 10 years ago, more or less, but for the last 5 years, I would say it's becoming something normal. Now 3D printers can be used in medicine, or they can be used to create prostheses, like a bionic arm for someone that lost the arm. Probably, if you are like me, a normal person, you don't know that much about 3D printing. And today I want to tell you the principle, the basic of 3D printing. So the first question is how it works, of course. So you need a 3D printer, which is like a normal printer, but instead of printing over a page, it prints in three dimensions, like length, width, and height. That word is called 3D printing. And as you use ink in a printer, you need ink in a 3D printer. And the ink is a plastic filament. There are three main materials: ABS, PLA, and PVA. Usually people use PLA, which means polylactic acid, and it's a polymer. And the good thing about this polymer is that it's biodegradable. And you know that I am called sustainable teacher, right? It is biodegradable in 100 years. And if you want to biodegrade this before, you need like a lot of temperatures and enzymes. But at least in 100 years, it will disappear. It's not that bad. The other are like thousands of years, like plastics. So it's the best solution among the worst. About 3D printers, there are two main types, and it depends on if the base, the bed, is heated or cold. Apart from that, which are the main steps for 3D printing? The first step is designing. Of course, you have to create your idea, your design. And then, as you know, printers print from bottom to top. They print by layers. So they do a layer, then another. So in each layer they print in width and depth. And when we add one layer to another, we are printing in height. To send the design from your computer, from your software, to the 3D printer, we have to do a process called slicing. Slicing in kitchen is like cutting in layers. Usually when you can slice a piece of bread, when you have your baguette and you cut it in round things, this is slicing, and the round thing is a slice. So slicing in the 3D printing is the same. We are going to divide our design in layer, in slices, so the printer knows how to do, what to do in each layer. And of course, we need an extruder, which is like the head. It's like in a normal printer, we have a head that is the one that distributes the ink on our paper. In this case, the head is called an extruder, and usually this extruder is really hot, like 100 or even 200 Celsius degrees. It depends on the type of filament. Actually, ABS is the filament that needs most temperature, PLA is medium temperature, and PVA is the temperature is lower. And by the way, I forgot to tell you that in the case of PVA, it could be dissolved in water. When designing, we have to bear in mind three main things. We should think about the size, because you can design something that with the size of a 1 meter, 10 meters. But then the bed of your printer is 10 centimeters. So you won't be able to print that in your 3D printer. So when designing your object, please bear in mind your size. Then you have to think also about the positions. As I told you, we have depth, width, and height. So if you remember about maths coordinate, this is related with X, Y, and Z coordinates. So when you are using coding software to design, usually you are going to use these three coordinates to make your design. It's not that important if you are using a graphic designer, but I think you should know it anyway. As I told you, the 3D printer is going to do in the base, in the bed, the first layer,
then the fourth,
and this way. So please try not to leave protrusions without contact with the base. Why? Because if you start, like, imagine that you want to do a triangle and you want to do an inverted triangle. So, well, no, a triangle is a bidimensional pyramid, okay? But you want to do it inverted. So you put the peak on the base and it start opening, right? This is a pyramid. If I told you that the peak is gonna be the first layer and this is gonna be in contact with the bed, but when the printer prints and on the beginning the filament is hot, it could be melted, it's not rigid, what would happen? Of course the layer will start falling down and you won't have a pyramid at all. So try not to leave protrusions, okay, without contact with the base. Of course there are some tricks for in the slicer to make protrusions, but if you do lots of protrusions and you don't have a really good 3D printer, it won't work. And now we are going to learn about Tinkercad, because this is the software that we are going to use for our design and the slicer, but I promise it's gonna be really short. So the first thing that you have to do is going to Tinkercad. You can look for Tinkercad on Google or Ecosia if you want a more sustainable option, and you will find it probably the first or second result. You enter into Tinkercad and now we have to sign in. We have to register. To register, we will click here and remember to use your school email, and if you don't have any authorization, ask your parents first. Now we are going to fill the data. You have to add your birth date, your country, and your password. And now we are in. The first thing that we are going to do is to create a design. We are going to skip the tutorial because I'm the tutorial. And now we are inside the designer. What I love about Tinkercad is that invent names for your design, but here in this corner you can change the name. I'm going to put example one. And in here you have a grid. Each small square is 1 millimeter, but you also can change the dimensions. I like the 1 millimeter grid because it's like our normal grid. And the good thing is that now imagine that you can start adding objects. In here you can change the color, you can change the size, okay? Look. The length, whatever, okay? So, and you can also drag from this square or in this cone on the top, and now it's floating, okay? What else? I don't know, in this case it's gonna be the base. You can modify also from here, we can write 5, and now it's gonna be 5 millimeters, by the way. So you can do these kind of things. Then you have Scribble. In Scribble you can do what you want, you say ready, and you will see the result in 3 dimensions. And of course this is only basic forms. You can also use text and numbers, so you can write things, characters, different shapes, so you can create anything you want with this. Imagine that you've finished with your design. Now you have to, well, usually it saves by itself, but I come back to the dashboard. This way I make sure that it is going to be safe. Now we can come back and we can download it. And to download it, we are going to use the STL extension, because this is the one that we are going to use for our slicer. And now we are going to use the Prusa Slicer. It's just a simple slicer software. So we are going to import our file with the STL format. But I forgot to show you something, and it's the filling. Because when we print, it's not like a full layer of plastic filament. It is just like, you will see like the external walls, and inside it's not absolutely filled. There are spaces. They create like a diagonal web. So they save material, they save filament. And depending on how hard should your design be or not, or how light should it be or heavy, you can use a different percentage or filling. I would say that 50% it's okay. If you need something stronger, maybe 20, 30 maximum. I haven't used anything higher than this. I would say 20 in this case. So now I'm gonna say export again, G-code, and I'm gonna save it here. And this is the file that, let's go to downloads. This is the file with the G-code that you should introduce in your 3D printer to use it. I hope you learned the basic principles of 3D printing in this video. When using Tinkercad, just feel free to try everything. Just be aware of if you're on the base or you're floating or under the base, and look from different perspective, because sometimes from a perspective it seems that one piece is next to the other one, and if you look from another side it could be really far away. Okay, leave in the comments if this video was interesting to you, if you have ever done a 3D design before, or if you have a 3D printer at home and you are an absolute expert on this. And of course, see you soon.